guys. Thanks for tuning in to another video. Quick video today on benchmark price and house price index for May of 2024. We're going to be comparing three markets like we've done in the past. I like to do this because it gives a very local perspective, more of a regional perspective, and a national perspective. So Hastings, Prince Edward County, seeing how that compares with Greater Toronto Area, and seeing how that compares with Canada as a whole. So let's get into the numbers. So for the month of May, benchmark price in Hastings and Prince Edward County sitting at $592,600. That's up 1.3% year over year and up 5.7% year to date. Greater Toronto is $1,117,400. That's down 3.5% year over year and up almost 5%, 4.9% year to date. Canada sitting around in the middle, $733,300, that's down again, just like Toronto, 2.4% year over year and up 3.5% year to date. When we get into the house price index numbers, like I said in the past, this is the same data as benchmark price, it's just a different figure. It's a base value of 100 starting in January of 2005, like I've said in the past. So same percentage increases and decreases, but HPI, Hastings and Prince Edward County, sitting at 362.7. Greater Toronto, lower at 357.3. And Canada, much lower at 310.2. So those are all the numbers, but what do all these numbers mean? So let's start with Hastings and Prince Edward County, our local market, and then we'll segue that into Toronto and Canada and how those markets are performing. So Hastings, Prince Edward County, it's the only market that's up year over year. The other two have seen declines, although we saw increases in all three of these markets year to date. I think the year over year price increases are likely due to our market just having lower prices in general and homes having lower loan amounts, right? So people aren't as sensitive to interest rates, although they do make an impact. It's a difference if you have a $300,000 mortgage versus an $800,000 mortgage. So I think that's what's helped price stability in our market. It's also the only market that's increased month over month. So we saw month over month declines in these two other markets, Greater Toronto and Canada. Not the case in Hastings and Prince Edward County. We've actually saw month over month increases in every month from the month of January. So every month in 2024 saw an increase in Hastings and Prince Edward County. And again, I think you can attribute that to lower home prices, less leverage, and lower loan amounts. Next, we'll go over to the other two markets, so Greater Toronto and Canada as a whole. So these markets, although they're up year to date, they're actually both down year over year as far as benchmark price and HPI numbers are concerned, and down month over month as well, as I said. So I can attribute this to lower sales volume, I believe. If we went over the May sales volume numbers, we saw that sales volume was down in our market and pretty much down across the country. Maybe with the exception of Calgary, because that market seems to still be performing quite well. But when you have lower sales volume, more inventory come on, especially in markets like Toronto and Vancouver, where you have a lot of condo inventory, it becomes a race to the bottom in pricing. And if you want to get your condo sold when there's four other ones for sale in the building and they're all pretty identical units, you're likely going to have to compete on price to get your property sold. So that's what I can attribute this year over year decline, because we're seeing lower sales numbers and more inventory come to the market, not necessarily in a detached space. Obviously, I don't know that market that well because I don't work in that market, but just from seeing numbers and seeing headlines and talking to agents who work there, that seems to be the case. So it will be interesting to see if these continue after we see the June numbers as far as sales volume, average price, etc. Because we did have quite a lackluster May with so much anticipating around potential rate cuts, which did happen. That's really it. Not much to report for this week's video, but it is encouraging to see Hastings and Prince Edward County, our local market, performing quite well compared to Toronto, which we're so closely tied to, and Canada as a whole. So we're basically the opposite for them, although every market's up year to date. We're up year over year. Toronto and Canada are not. We're up month over month. Toronto and Canada are not. And that just speaks to strong market fundamentals here and seeing that although prices are high for people who have lived here and been around the area for a long time, they're still relatively low compared to other areas, which helps us during this environment of high interest rates because we have lower loan amounts and less leverage. So It will be interesting to see what the June numbers bring, if we still see this lower sales volume, kind of lackluster market and spring market, or if we see more homes come on. It'll definitely have a price impact. You know, if you have more inventory and not many sales and people need to sell their home, they're going to compete on price. But I suspect that likely won't be the case because we still aren't seeing all that inventory come on. And there is some pent-up demand, which was kind of weighing on the rate announcement, which we did see a rate decrease. And now people are pricing in another rate cut potentially in July or September. So stay tuned. We'll see what happens with the numbers. But as far as this week's video, reporting that Hastings and Prince Edward County are still performing well on benchmark price and HPI front. Thank you guys for watching this video, and stay tuned for another video next week.